Do you root for sharks? Are you a Bears fan? Or are the Bengals more your team? Today, we're rooting for apex predators. Hey everyone, Crystal here for DNews. From saber-toothed tigers to imaginary monsters under our beds, powerful apex predators have caught human attention since prehistoric times. We imitate them, we worship them, we display their teeth, heads, and claws as trophies, and ultimately, we're completely terrified of them. Apex predators are so called because of their position at the very top of the food chain. You can think of the space they occupy in an ecosystem as the peak segment of the ecological pyramid. Nobody preys on them. And they eat the lower species making up the wider pyramid below. But today, I'm not here to talk about why we should be afraid of them. I'm here to tell you why we should all appreciate the apex predator for the helpful, stabilizing influences that they really are. Apex predators play a critical role in what scientists call the trophic cascade. The trophic level of an organism defines its position in the food chain, and apex predators sit at the highest trophic level. A cascade is described by something like, tiger sharks eat sea turtles that eat seagrass. Perhaps the most publicized example of a trophic cascade comes from Yellowstone National Park, and it all starts with the wolf. The culling of wolves from the park to near extinction in the 1930s and 40s led to severe consequences, including a reduction in biodiversity and a concerning disappearance of aspen, cottonwood, and willow trees due to overgrazing by elk. Several articles published by Beshta and Ripple from Oregon State University documented the impact of wolf reintroduction on diversity and landscape, demonstrating that wolves relieve the pressure placed on flora by herbivores, leading to more robust areas of woody growth, which consequently strengthen and improve habitats for species like bison. But there are multiple cascades affected by the size of the elk population, and for some, we might not have acted quickly enough. A decade-long study performed by scientists at Colorado State University and published in the Proceedings of the Royal Society B showed that after almost 100 years without them, simply reintroducing wolves wasn't enough for the park's waning willow tree, which are a tasty treat for elk. The willow tree supplies food and habitat for beavers, whose activities temper the seasonal ebbs and flows of river runoff, recharge the water table, and provide an ideal environment for fish. Now, even with elk populations back under predatory control, ecologists are discovering that they must gently finesse the balance between beaver and willow to halt riverbank erosion and channel widening, which of course have negative downstream consequences. See what I did there? This all just goes to show that when we attempt to pick one thing out of an ecosystem, like the scary and predatory wolf, we find it hitched to everything else and the system falls apart. Okay, at this point, you might be thinking, I get it, apex predators keep everything else in check, but what keeps apex predators in check so they don't overfeed and collapse an entire ecosystem on their own? Well, the answer to that is twofold. Of course, apex predators are sensitive to the availability of their prey. If they overhunt their territory, lack of available food will have a shrinking effect on their population. But apex predators are typically large animals with longer gestation periods, so reproducing takes time and a lot of energy. A recent study published in the journal Oikos even suggested that community behavior might come into play, observing that some apex predators control the size of their own populations through infanticide and preferential breeding. Either way, the energy demands to hunt, defend their territory from intruders, breed, and raise their young are very high for apex predators. This means that much of their time is dedicated to defense and reproduction, and that they only hunt when they have to, which is just another reason to respect apex predators. For some apex predators of the sea, tune into Shark Week, which kicks off Sunday, June 26th at 8, 7 Central, or watch this video by Tara on what we can do to keep sharks from going extinct.
Overfishing is a huge problem globally, and in the past couple decades alone, the demand for sharks has gone way up. People hunt them for their meat, fins, cartilage, liver, skin, and teeth, and they often die in brutal, inhumane ways.
So what do you think? Do predators make the world a better place, or should we let our herbivore friends graze in peace? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching.